Hello, my name is Gayla Arrindell and I'm with the In-Building Networks team at Corning Optical Communications. Today I will be discussing some of the trends driving the need to solve cellular in buildings. Building owners today are faced with many technology trends, such as the Internet of Things, 5G, Wi-Fi 6 and CBRS to name a few, and have to make many decisions to keep their employees, tenants, guests, and customers connected now and into the future. According to Cisco, by 2023, there will be 30 billion connected devices. 45% of these will be mobile. Connectivity has become the fourth building utility. Just like we expect a building to have water, gas, and electricity, connectivity has become an expectation, both wired and wireless. As we walk into a building, we expect to be able to use either Wi-Fi or cellular, or preferably both. Think also of smart buildings, and the sensors and devices are nearly all the things making them smart. Utilities and lighting, audiovisual and security systems, parking garages, etc. Add wearables and augmented reality, and you begin to envision how critical connectivity is inside buildings. It is estimated that 80% of mobile usage takes place in buildings, and in these unprecedented times, one may say it's closer to 100%. Enterprises are moving towards a universal wireless strategy. Wi-Fi continues to be the primary technology for data usage, with its ability to effectively drive high-capacity applications. But Wi-Fi is challenged to deliver reliable voice. Cellular is needed for effective coverage, being able to make and receive calls from anywhere in a building. In addition, cellular data is used to augment capacity with its highly secure connectivity protocols. Green energy efficient buildings are not cell friendly. Metallic structures and high efficiency windows block over 90% of cellular signals from coming into the building. Sharp corners and large spaces create dead spots, concrete walls are hard for cellular signals to penetrate, and high-rise and high-density areas generate massive cellular interference. Cellular coverage is critical in emergency situations, with 51% of all 911 calls originating from cellular devices in buildings, and mass communication via text messaging has become an important emergency communication tool. Data shows that 65% of emergency responders have experienced a communication failure in a building. According to the Safer Buildings Coalition, saving 1 minute of emergency response time in a building will save 10,000 lives a year. 5G is coming, and it's coming fast. It'll bring 10 times faster data speeds and lower connection latency, driving the growth of the massive Internet of Things, artificial intelligence and virtual reality, as well as self-driving vehicles. 5G needs fiber and lots of it to transmit the vast amount of data that will be generated. But 5G will roll out over time. It'll be less of an event and more of a pathway. Carriers will start by upgrading cell towers and building out the backhaul and front haul to connect these towers. 5G will also be used to provide dramatic capacity improvements in high cellular traffic locations, such as stadiums, airports, and conference centers. With the shift to 5G, operator funding for enterprise in-building cellular has essentially dried up. The vast majority of enterprise locations are on their own, left with two choices to provide cellular coverage: wait and hope, or make a strategic cellular investment. Cellular coverage in buildings provides a strategic advantage that results in improved workplace productivity and collaboration, increased safety with the ability to make calls anywhere in the building, improved security beyond what Wi-Fi can provide, and the capacity to enable 5G and the benefit it promises.